Dr. Nedim Selim from Turkey to enlighten us with his talk on non-crisp cross-linked HA fillers.
I all have problems in connecting my laptop. I moved my presentation to another laptop, but also we have some small problems, so we will see. Because I show videos, this is why it's important to use the app. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, we will see. Good morning. It will be very short. Thank you very much for Dr. Lim, Dr. Khalid, Dr. Saha. Nothing much left to talk, but I will do some polishing here. Well, okay. Well, it is so why it is so important first to examine the patient. This is very important here because, of course, there are different types of treatments, but the most important thing here is to do the examination of the patient. And here I have some videos. All of us know how to approach the patient and what to do in the examination, but I would like just to do some small videos here. Of course, in the examination, we have to see the patient under indirect angled light here, because we need to know the type of the scar that we want to treat. So the first approach is to see the patient under indirect light. And the second most important thing in the examination is to touch the patient and do some lifting, and we pull the skin to see if it is becoming better or not. And when it becomes smoother, that means it's more like an atrophic and a tethered scar, because in our subject we are talking about dermal fillers and HA, non-crest-linked HA, and of course subcision also is very important in this procedure to put the filler inside. So that's why doing the examination of the patient is very important. Animation also is very important, because if we make the patient laugh, we can see if there will be any lifting or pull here. As you see, I don't need to use the pointer here, so it's shown there. So when we see that it is lifting or pulling or there is indentation, that means there are tethering there and there are bands which is holding the skin under and there is under the scar. So that's why in these patients we have to do the examination here. So I'm shifting from one here because this is must say for me. Okay. I'm not going to talk about the types of scars because all of us know it, but the most important thing here that we, when we try to use the HA fillers or non-crosslink hyaluronic acids, it's better to decide on patients which they have tethered and atrophic scars. Because as Dr. Saar said that in the, when the patients are older, they lose volume also and stuff, and this skin becomes very thin. So that's why you need to improve under the skin by using different materials, and one of them is HA and cross-links and non-cross-links. The most important thing here after examination, we have to do the mapping of the patient, because when we try to do the subcision, in order not to lose the area that we want to subsize or to fill it inside, it's always better to circle it or to do a dotting here in the mapping. Photograph is very important here. We should not forget about this. And this is true because patients forget. I know that we are human beings are very, our brain, sometimes we say that we are like in Turkey, like a fish brain. We forget everything. But patients, they forget quicker. So that's why we have to show them that what was before and after. Okay, in the subcision here, it's a small surgical procedure done in clinic. The idea here is just to release the bands under the skin. And just I would like to show a very quick video also. You can use the 18 gauge needle, and also there is a no core technique, also it's a different type of needle. The idea, again, you go inside the skin, you do like a wiping technique just to release the bands, and then when you make a tunnel inside, then you release the bands and you make the skin loose, and then after that you can decide if to put any material inside. It's better to put a softer cross-link hyaluronic acid, because we don't want these bands to be bonded again, so that's why we need a spacer here, and the spacer is a low concentration cross-link hyaluronic acid. Also, we can do here tunneling, but we can use the standard needle, which is a 30 or 27 gauge needle, and when we do the small tunneling with the filler injector, after we do the tunneling, we start injecting very, very small amounts, like a micro droplets here. This is to stimulate the skin, and to we can have a good collagen formation, elastin formation, and also filling here. And when we have fillers and we want only directly without any substitution, even we can use non-crossing here. It's always we have to be careful to use a very thin product, because we don't want to have any nodules, because we are working very superficially here. So you can see in this technique, we just use the 30 gauge needle, we little bit push it outward, put a small drop, and then massage it, and then we keep it like this. Okay, and then I think I am finished. So this is about hyaluronic acid, we know about this. Okay, so tunneling, we saw this, and thank you very much for listening. And if you have any questions, thank you very much.